la casa te cayó encima todos los cables.
Wow. Entonces, ah,
el
eso.
Poste donde yo me suplía está una finca allá abajo. Entonces todo ese sector se suplía del mismo poste. Pero como ellos quedan ahí abajo, ves que allá hay una carretera, energía eléctrica los energizó de los postes que hay allá abajo. Entonces yo, como quiera, como ves, quedo lejos del poste de ahí y quedo lejos entonces de la calle de allá. Yo me le fui detrás después de la cita médica, conseguí el supervisor y lo traje ahí. Y él dijo, vamos a marcar el área para que te puedan venir a resolver el problema. Se fueron y nada. Traje dos supervisores más por el área de acá. Cuando pusieron ese poste, lo traje acá. Ese fue el que me dijo que aquí entonces habría que poner como tres postes más para que el cable llegara hasta ahí.
Pero no es más fácil mover la prensa para el frente.
Pues habría que poner tres postes más.
Well, it turns out that she's the only lady that has no energy around here, right? That's correct. She's the only person. Now, check it out. Every single person out here on my back, they have energy. Anyone that is up the hill has energy. She's the only person that doesn't have energy just for one reason. That's a light pole right here. This tree fell on top of the lines, disconnecting the light pole. And supposedly, the only light pole that it could be installed to help her is going to be around this area right here. And it's supposed to be with a helicopter, right? Just one person, and they're not going to spend the money for just one person, which is stupid. But so that is why we are here. We're going to help you out.
8 months. Without
8 months?
Yeah.
Wow.
Pues lo he visto en la televisión. Pero yo soy una sola persona, necesito un solo poste, so a mí no me, ya yo he llamado varias veces a Energía Eléctrica y ellos pues están bregando. El primero que me atendió, que fue un supervisor en Energía Eléctrica, me preguntó, ¿usted es la única que le falta luz? Yo dije, sí. Me dijo, ah, pues es que estamos concentrándonos en comunidades completas primero. Eso fue lo que me contestó. Y yo, en serio, después que ellos energicen las comunidades completas, entonces van a ir a los partidos.
Entonces, ¿qué te van a ayudar?
Si es que me ayudan y si se olvidan de mí. Porque yo soy la única. Eso es lo que a mí me preocupa. Y conste que traje tres supervisores de las diferentes brigadas que vinieron aquí. Uno solo quería ayudarme, pero él trajo el supervisor, él quería poner un poste aquí en este terreno de ahí detrás de la casa para tirar el cable. Pero él trajo el supervisor y parece que no se lo permitió porque como esa casa está abandonada, no tienen a quien pedirle permiso para poner el poste de ahí. Me parece que no lo dejaron. Pero él iba a romper la cadena y a traer un camión para hacer el hoyo y poner el poste de él. Claro, él le tenía que preguntar al supervisor de él.
Exacto.
Y no lo dejaron.
So, literally, she has a neighbor. I'm going to show you how fast we could get there. The light pole's like right in front of her house, but no one's going to help her because they need to put like three more light poles, right?
Two more, three more.
So three light poles, they could do it in one day. They rather not do it because they want to hire a helicopter. That's so stupid.
En ese tiempo no tenían poste. Entonces lo que dijeron es podían ponerlo en las palmas y yo le dije que no, yo no voy a tener cables en palmas. Viene otro evento atmosférico, me tiran las palmas frente a mi casa y puede tener un chorro de cables frente a mi casa y eso es muy peligroso.
So we are trying to talk to her. Okay, let me go over here. I was explaining everything that we're going to try to do with her to like try to get another fridge, try to turn on a bunch of lights. Like give her the do's and do nots. And anyway, I just wanted her to say thank you to you guys because you're the ones that are actually helping for people like her to get some power before next hurricane season. So
yes.
Anything that you want to say to them?
Yes. I really appreciate the efforts that you do to help other people. This is a great experience for me. I'm not used to having people donate me things. All the contrary, I like to help other people. So I really appreciate what you guys are doing for me. This is going to change my life. I've been without energy for 8 months, and so hopefully soon I will be able to have a normal life and be able to help others as well with the help that you guys are giving me. Thank you very much.
Perfect. You see, guy, we're turning on a smile and we haven't installed anything yet. So
those dogs hate me.
They
hear everybody. Oh, this is the other option.
Then I don't have that stretcher where you can energize from the front of my house. So the other supervisor said that they would have to put like a pole here and two more over there in order to throw the cable to my pole, which is in the back. Or I'd either have to make a stretcher here, which costs a lot of money, to be able to throw the cable from here to here.
So this is the funny part. It's not so funny because she's been without power for like 8 months. But here's the deal. That's her house. That's the neighbor house. That guy has power. She doesn't have power. So literally, you just have to take the cable from here all the way to there. And her problem would be done. It would be fixed. Finito. Nada. But no, they need to put like a light bulb over here, another one over there, another one over there, all the way up to the back of the house so they can actually turn on their house. So which is, what's the word I'm looking for?
Ridiculous.
What else? What else do we have? Stupid? Inefficient?
Funny?
Interesting, funny, yeah. So that's the situation. It's. Let me ask you something. How do you feel every time that you come home and you see your neighbor with lights, but you don't? How does it feel?
In the beginning, I was really mad.
Yeah.
Then I was frustrated, and I get here at night, and so I don't have a way to be able to light myself. I have to get out, and I have to roll the
gate. Right. So she has a gate right there, and you have to, like, even if it's raining, you have to get out of the car, open it up,
pass the car, close it to be able to park my car back,
and then you,
at night.
At night, and you just, and this is the funny part.
Well, it's not so funny. I keep saying funny, but it's not funny. So when you come to her house, this is where it comes frustration. It kicks in. Your neighbor has lights, and you see a bunch of lights during the night over there. So she got the most spectacular view, but it's also like a reminder that how, right?
Yeah, it's a frustrating view because everyone has electricity now and I don't.
Yeah. So this is why we do this, guys. This is why I love doing this, because people like her tends to go under the radar, and there they will say, oh, we turn on the lights on every single house in Puerto Rico, and it's a lie. I keep saying that. People don't believe me. It's a lie. There's a lot of people in need, and this is why we're going to help her. And I need your help to do bigger one this time. Bigger means better. Sometimes. Not every time. Okay.
Nos vemos el 11.
Okay. Nos vemos.
Te bendiga mucho.
Gracias.
Say bye, guys.
Bye.
See you later.
Take care.